join us here in the studio, it's so easy. Just go to www.channel4.com/drop, or you can download the mobile app, and it's totally free. So let's welcome, get ready everybody, for our next set of contestants. There's four of them. They're here playing for charity. All rise, it's the boys from Blue!
15 million album sales, 13 top 10 hits. Tonight, can the boys from Blue, Duncan, Simon, Lee and Anthony beat the drop?
Obviously, you know, you're used to being in the limelight and doing gigs and everything like that, and you must have some sort of way of preparing for concerts, but this is different. Yeah. How have you prepared for this?
Reading loads of papers.
How do you prepare to play
we've
with
lost
a million
millions
quid?
Before it.
Guys are playing for charity tonight,
yes,
aren't you?
Yeah.
You're all playing for the same charity, which is really great. Can you tell me a little bit about the Teenage Cancer Trust and what they do?
Yeah, it's a fantastic charity, actually. We had an opportunity to go and visit one of the units, and they do special units for teenagers and young people with cancer. And it's amazing what they do, and we got an opportunity to go around and see it all. So it is a great, great charity and a great cause, and hopefully we're going to win lots of money for it.
Well, we hope so too. I'm just warning everybody at home that Anthony, he does giggle when he's stressed out. So if Anthony just loses it, we know that, see, it started. Okay, there it is. It's £1 million. I want to know how much of that you guys can keep hold of over the next seven questions. Do you understand the rules?
Yes.
Fantastic.
My arms are sweating.
You're a team, so you guys don't get a choice of category. Right. But your first category is...
Hey.
So, footballers. Okay. So, who's going to do it?
It's Simon.
Okay, Simon and Anthony. It's you. You've got £1 million. I've got seven questions. Let's all play the million band
right,
rock. Good luck, boys. On your red mark, please. Okay. Good luck, boys. So, the four possible answers in the footballers category are Paul Scholes, David Beckham, Ryan Giggs, Gary Neville. Take a look at this. This picture of former Man United teammates on a night out was taken earlier this week. And the question is, which of these footballers played the fewest Premier League games for Manchester United?
Bex or Neville? Wait, when did Beckham leave?
Beckham left in 2003, went to Real Madrid.
Yeah.
Gary Neville was just retired last season.
Beckham,
yeah?
Yeah. So where are we going?
We're going
Bex,
yeah?
Which of these footballers played the fewest Premier League games for Manchester United? 45 seconds on the clock.
Giggs has played over 8 on nearly 1,000. Bex.
Still going.
This takes ages.
Wait, it's got all in the red.
All right, man, calm down.
30 seconds.
Oh, my God, what's going on?
What's going on, man?
Bro.
What? It's done nerve-wracking!
20 seconds.
Right, take it easy.
20 seconds.
Yeah.
15.
Right.
Is that
Gary
right?
Neville's on...
Fine. 10.
Yeah,
it's 9.
It's going.
8. Oh, these footballers played the fewest Premier League games for Manchester United. You were £1 million sure it was David Beckham.
Please, Bex.
So let's see what's going to drop.
Oh,
United. Giggs has played over 600 Premier League games for United. Scholes around 500, but Beckham 265. Oh my gosh, you really do know your football, you two. Move your money back. Because apparently they look mega nervous downstairs.
Really
they were really,
were they?
Really worried.
Imagine
going out on that night out.
That
I thought that
face.
Picture was so good. Because I'm not really even that into football, but I just thought that would be such a good night
out,
wouldn't it?
Yeah,
they used to play tricks on
people in the Northwest did best on that question, unsurprisingly, but well done anyway. Right, it's time now for question 2 of 7, so here's your category. Museums.
I ain't got a Scooby-Doo.
Me neither.
Okay, well, just bear in mind, you've got 7 questions to get through, but you have got Lee and Duncan waiting. You can swap around if you want. So would you like to swap?
I don't know anything about museums.
I went on a school trip once. I got banned. Like, I was too naughty, so no.
So what are you going to do? Remember, once you're out, you can't come back in.
Really?
So if you leave now, it's going to be Duncan and Lee for the rest, all 6 questions.
What do you think?
It's common sense, I would imagine, isn't it? What do you reckon?
You like to think so, but...
Guys, I'm going to have to...
You want me to stay?
...push you for choice.
I'm going to...
OK,
I'm
so who are you going to swap with?
With Duncan.
OK, Duncan, make your way to the drop. Simon, you've done everything you can. Thanks so much. Really happy about that choice, didn't you?
I haven't got a Scooby-Doo about museums, I'm sorry.
Well, this will be interesting then, won't it? So the 4 possible answers in the museums category are...
Let's have a look.
Tattoos. Sex. Marijuana. Rock and roll. And the question is this. Which of these subjects does not have a public museum in Amsterdam specifically devoted to it?
Right, they do have a marijuana one in Amsterdam.
They must have a sex museum, though.
They have a sex museum.
They do, yeah.
I don't know if they have a tattoo museum. Do you reckon they have a rock and roll museum in Amsterdam?
The clock starts. Which of these subjects does not have a public museum in Amsterdam devoted to?
Which does not? It's not them two, because they do have...
Tattoos. When we went to Amsterdam, have we ever seen...
Seconds.
I don't know. Stick some on rock and roll and stick some on tattoos, because I'm not sure, bro.
All right.
What do you reckon?
For a fact, you're right. They must have...
There's not.
They've got to have a sex museum.
No, they have a sex museum.
They must have, yeah.
I've been to it.
Have you?
Yeah. And I went... They've got a...
Must have been when I weren't looking.
And of course they've got a marijuana...
I can't say. Which of these subjects does not have a public museum in Amsterdam specifically devoted to it? You had split your money 50-50 between tattoos and rock and roll, but you decided to load up rock and roll, so 300,000 on tattoos, 700,000 on rock and roll.
They've got to.
Let's see what's going to drop.
I don't know. Oh. I can't cope with this stress.
Oh, my...
Okay. Right, so we got... Okay, we got something.
Yes!
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 Oh, really?
I was worried. Well, there are a lot of great tattoo artists in Amsterdam, but tattoos... So home to Amsterdam Tattoo Museum. Oh, yes, it's the knot. I was worried. Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, my God, the knot caught me out there. So, it's home to the Hash Marijuana and Hemp Museum. It's home to the Amsterdam Sex Museum. And it is home to Amsterdam Tattoo Museum. Yes, but the only Dutch rock and pop museum is near Rotterdam. You've moved. You're moving back. Oh, I caught myself out there. never thought when you went to the sex museum that you never thought this could come in handy for...
Handy?
Yeah, like... Oh, crikey, Duncan, stop it. I have to say that 80% of your fans who are playing online got that question right.
Well done, Blue fans.
So well done, Blue fans. I bet you must be very proud of them. They're doing a very good job. So five questions to go, £700,000 still in play, and the boys from Blue are going to be facing question three after the break. That's brilliant stuff.